Aloha. You're watching F5 On Demand. I'm Senior Technical Marketing Manager Peter Silva. We're in San Francisco for VMworld 2014, booth 1621. If you're at the show, please come on by and see us. And so one of the things, as you saw over our shoulders at the top of the video, is this software-defined data center, the SDDC. We're actually handing out t-shirts this week for it. And so I thought I'd get Brandon Frelick. He's our marketing services architect for our cloud and security solutions. First time on the show, Brandon. Thanks for joining me.
Thanks for having me, Peter.
He's actually a teammate, so you know we're gonna have some fun. But in all seriousness, you know, as organizations are moving toward this software-defined data center model, really, what are some of the things that they need to consider from a security perspective as they're moving to these SDDCs?
Well, as these SDDCs are building out, they're sprawling applications, right? So one of the primary concerns they're going to have is, as the applications are moving to HTTP 2.0, and this concept of SSL everywhere, is going to be key certificate management and the proliferation of keys and certificates across their environment, right? And additionally, as those applications are building and being brought up and moving very quickly from a development environment to a QA to a production environment, right? You want to be able to secure those applications and provide a layer 4 through 7 security policy on top of those, because as much as we'd like to think, nobody really provides a straight out of the box, robust, secure solution on their first go around.
Yeah.
So being able to secure those and wrap that around your policy as you're deploying these applications is a key.
And is one of the considerations too, making sure that, I mean, could an organization have the same policy throughout, or would the policy maybe adjust depending upon, you know, whether they're in a physical environment or a virtual environment?
No, the policy could be the same across any of those. You know, we have the ability to synchronize policies across all platforms, whether they be our virtual edition or our hardware, which allows you that flexibility. But you can get down to the level of providing a very granular policy, or just have a very base policy that is aware of the application and has some ability to learn the application before going full production and exposing it to the internet or other nefarious actors on the internet.
Yeah. Right. And so, a lot of what you're talking about right now is really protecting against those inbound attacks, no matter where those applications are, providing the services to protect such things. What about also, I would think, you know, as applications are moving around the globe, another area might be identity and access management, wouldn't it?
Oh, absolutely, right? You want to provide the same access policy to your constituents, whether they're in your local data center or they're in a cloud hosted environment, you know, public cloud. Absolutely, you want to be able to provide the same authentication resources and provide that same level of authentication and access management to the.
And I guess one of the challenges would be, you know, with many of these cloud instances, particularly SaaS applications, an organization having to put their user store, their data in that cloud, and that's a risky proposal, isn't it, for some organizations?
Well, absolutely. I mean, you have compliance issues and all kinds of additional security issues that you have to think about when you put an application in the cloud, right? You know, it's somebody else's data center, and what are their responsibilities for that data? And then who has access to it? You want to be able to control that access, not delegate the access control to third party.
And so when you mean control, that really means in terms of your Active Directory, if you will, or you know, any other type, is pretty much keeping it in-house and using, say, a big IP, for instance, to then do that identity management, to then toss that user over to where their services or resources are, right?
Yeah, toss them.
Toss them, you like that one?
Here you go. No, you definitely want to be able to control that and have that granular level of access control that you manage locally, and then be able to provide those resources and delegate that out on a need basis.
Pretty cool, so I do appreciate it. I just think, you know, it's one of those things where, you know, I think software-defined data center, SDN, all of this software-defined X are these buzzwords in the industry. And I think a lot of organizations are kind of wondering, you know, how do I get there? What do I do? And if I do, since a lot of this is about managing business risk, you know, what are the risks and how do I then, to some extent, mitigate those risks as I start to move into a software-defined data center?
Yeah, absolutely, it's all about risk management.
Yeah. So a little bit more. I really appreciate your time, Brandon. Some a little conversation about some security implications or security considerations from one of our smart security guys. And as you start to deploy your software-defined data centers. His, mine, ours. Our software-defined data center. So for Brandon, I got Natasha behind the lens. Thanks a lot, Natasha. I just grabbed you out of the blue. I'm Peter, and we're with F5 Networks. Thanks for watching.